read it and found out what was in it. Linda McMahon is the chair of the Board for America First Policy Institute. Now, previously, she served in President Trump's cabinet as administrator of the Small Business Administration. Linda McMahon joins us now via Skype. Linda, good to see you. Thank you for joining us. You're sounding the alarm about this House reconciliation bill. Tell us what other bad stuff is in this that we are not aware of, going to kneecap small businesses.
Well, first of all, let's call it what it is. This is really big government socialism grab power wish list. It's not just the reconciliation bill. I mean, that's what it is. You know, President Biden campaigned on the fact that he wanted to transform America. Well, that's exactly what he wants to do. And he wants to take away the opportunity of small businesses to really grow and experience the American dream. And if this bill is allowed to pass, that's exactly what's going to happen. There's so much in this. Let's look, first of all, just the taxes. I mean, Biden said that he wouldn't tax incomes, you know, over 400,000. But what's going to happen with small businesses who are those businesses that are passed through, if you will? But also there are about 8 million of the 37 million businesses, small businesses in our country that, you know, pay taxes at the C Corp level. So if their taxes go from 21% to 27%, 28%, that's going to be a big impact on these businesses. So we're just in for a lot of surprises, if you will, if this this big government socialism bill passes.
I'm ever more grateful for people like Joe Manchin and Kristen Sinema. I may not agree with them on every issue, but boy, am I glad that they're listening to their constituencies. And it's interesting, too, because Manchin coming from West Virginia, people forget that was a state that went for Trump by double digits. And I think it's hysterical that they think Manchin's going to turn tail and support this, you know, the socialist plan coming from Democrats on this. Not going to happen. And he understands, Linda, that here you have, what, 60% of the new jobs that have been created in this country have come from these small businesses that are going to get hit with all these taxes. You mentioned C Corps. We had a conversation just a couple weeks ago about S Corps and, of course, capital gains taxes. Everything that's in this is just disastrous. And we were just coming out of this lockdown as well and doing so incredibly well because of the policies from the previous administration that Biden seemingly is reversing now. Well, I mean, what is this going to do to any kind of recovery, real recovery?
But surely it's going to reverse the recovery. We have such a healthy economy right now coming out of COVID because of the policies that were put in under the administration. Those policies which created, the best jobs for women and for Hispanics and for African Americans. We saw taxes decrease, regulations decreased. So our economy was thriving and then COVID hit. But we're able to have this recovery coming out because of those policies. Now, if the big government socialism bill passes, we're going to raise taxes. We're going to raise regulations, increase regulations again. And, you know, there's a little point in this bill that I wrote an op-ed on, I think it was last week or week before, about unions and small businesses and what it can do to small businesses today. The unions who now want to come in and unionize, it will go more after employers than they will employees, because employees can still have their private vote and employers can have, you know, a little muscle put on them because it will cost them more to operate as a non-union. So, you know, there's so many hidden parts to this this government grab for power, I think, that we just need to pay attention to, because it's going to crush small businesses. It really will.
Yeah, and of course, the corporate tax rate, I think they're wanting to raise it to where we'd be the highest corporate tax rate in the world. I can't imagine. Well, I mean, it's right. So anti-business.
Well, that's right. And if you look at the fact that if you combine what state tax would be and the increases for small businesses, they could be paying as much as 31% of the taxes. And it's just out of the question. For these small businesses, it literally can put them out of business.
Yes, it definitely would. And they've been the ones who have outlasted at least the lockdown and everything else, that they've made it this long only to see these regulations come in and these higher taxes from this new administration. Talking with Linda McMahon. Linda, I wanted to ask you, too, about some of the Joe Biden's remarks where he says that, well, everyone's getting a higher wage. And I'll never forget that one exchange. And I think it was Peter Ducey and Jen Psaki. I think it was Peter Ducey who was asking Jen Psaki this. And she was talking about how the administration had wanted people, even in fast food, to pay like $15 an hour. But because everyone was getting paid to stay home, a lot of these entities had to actually offer way more than the market would actually dictate to support such a job. And Ducey was asking her about this. And she's like, yeah, wages are up. You know, people are making more than ever. But the question then was, well, how does that work with inflation? Because it doesn't matter if you're making more, if you're making a little bit more, inflation's knocking down the value of your dollar. So there really isn't a gain for anyone who says that they might be making more now. Linda, what can you tell us about this?
Well, that's absolutely true. But just look now, I mean, consumers are feeling the pinch already in their pocketbooks. When they go to the gas tank, when they go to buy groceries, they're already seeing the rate of inflation. And this is before this bill even gets passed. I mean, inflation is here today. And I don't think it's transitory. It is here to stay for a while, and it's just going to continue to eat away at our economy. Because small businesses aren't going to be able to support it. Consumers today can't support it because they don't have as much cash in their pocket if you really look at the fact that prices are up.
Yeah, very much so. Linda McMahon, appreciate what you do. And I tell you, I never actually thought the tweets were mean myself, but I'd take some of those mean tweets any day of the week right now compared to what we're getting from this administration, I tell you. Linda, good to see you. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Dana.
Of course.